Children, in this video, we will be solving the back exercises. So let us start on with the first one. Take the correct answer. Who succeeded Chandragupta II? The answer is Kumar Gupta. Second, which of the following is a Sanskrit dictionary? It is Amara Kosha. Amar Kosha. Then see the third one. Who founded Gupta dynasty? The answer is Sri Gupta. Then we come to the fourth one. The great physician of the Gupta period was Dhanvantri. Which caste lived outside the village? It is the B1, that is Chandalas. Okay. Now let us come to the next exercise, filling the blank. So the first one, the Gupta age is known as the golden period of Indian history. Second, Chandragupta II assumed the title of Shakari. Okay. Samudra Gupta did not annex the southern kingdoms. He took only dash from them. In the second one, it is tributes. Tributes. Then we come to the fourth one, the two great grammarians. The word is grammarians of this period were Panini and Patanjali. Okay. Then the fifth one, the greatest poet of Vikramaditya's court was Kalidasa. So the fifth one is poet. Then we come to the sixth. The masterpiece of art during the Gupta period is the image of seated Buddha in a yogic pose. So the answer is seated Buddha. Then seventh one, the centers of high learning during the Gupta age were Nalanda, Takshashila and Sarnath. Ujjain is also right and Ajanta is also right. So it's your wish which you want to write. Then eighth one, Varahamihira wrote dash an encyclopedia on astronomy. So the answer is Brihat Samhita. Ninth, the finest example of metallurgy of this period is iron pillar at Mehrauli in Delhi. Okay. The last one, dash was called the Indian Napoleon. The answer is Samudra Gupta. Now we move on to the third exercise, that is matchups. Okay. So let us see the first one, Shakari. The answer is even. Title given to Chandragupta II. Then the second is Tamralipti. The answer is famous port during the Gupta period. Third is Abhijayana Shakuntalam. It is written by Kalidasa. Then the fourth one, Allahabad pillar inscription. The answer is Harisena. The fourth is Harisena. Then see the fifth one, frescoes. It is Ajanta Caves. Sixth is Vishnu Sharma. It is wrote Panchatantra. Okay. Java, Sumatra and Cambodia. The answer is Guptas had trade relations with these countries. The last one is Aryabhatta and Varahamihira. So it is great astronomers. Now we start on with the fourth one, that is state whether the following statements are true or false. Chandragupta Vikramaditya was the founder of the Gupta dynasty. It is false. Then second is Chandragupta I ruled from CE 375 to CE 415. It is also false. Third one, Samudragupta is called the Indian Napoleon. True. Fahian, a Chinese traveler, visited India during Samudra Gupta's reign. That is also false. The last one, Skanda Gupta, was the last Gupta ruler. It is true. Now, children, we start on with answer the following questions. The first is, who was the first prominent king of Gupta Empire? You will write the first prominent king of the Gupta Empire was Chandragupta I. Okay, so the answer is Chandragupta I. Next, you see, children, this. Children, let us start on with the second answer. Here we have to explain the military achievements of Samudragupta and the source which tells us about him. So, come to page number 89, citing military achievements of Samudragupta. So, come to page number 89. Yes. So, here we will be writing the first one. He defeated, or instead of he, you can write Samudragupta. Samudragupta first. You will write the first point. Samudragupta was a great conqueror. Okay. And then second, you will write second point. He defeated as many as 9 rulers in northern India and 12 rulers in eastern Deccan. Third point, you will write Samudragupta's empire was mainly confined to North India. Okay. Then, after this, they are asking the second thing, which source tells us about him? So, here you will be writing again, come to page number 89, under the heading Samudragupta first para. You will write the Allahabad pillar inscription. The Allahabad pillar inscription tells us about him. Okay. Then, come to the third one. It is written, why is Chandragupta II considered the greatest ruler of the Gupta dynasty? So you will again we have to move to page number 89. So moving to eight now, page number 89 under the heading Chandragupta II. You will start the answer from the first point because, or we can write from the back, we will start. Chandragupta II is considered the greatest ruler of the Gupta dynasty because. After this, you will write the first point on page number 89 under the heading Chandragupta II. First point will be Chandragupta II was a great conqueror. Second point will be he destroyed. Destroy is written here. Before that, you will add the word he. Okay, he destroyed, ED, the power of the Shakas from the Malwa, Gujarat, and Saurashtra permanently. This will be the second point. Third point, you will write, gained control over 3 important ports of Bharuch, Kambay, and Sopara. Okay, this much you will be writing. So here we are having how many points? 3 points. Okay. Then after this, let us see the fourth point. It will be on page number 89 only. He was a great. Then come to page number 90. Conqueror and a good administrator, only up till administrator. Okay. Then fifth point we will write. He had at his court the famous Navratnas, the most learned men of his time. That's all. With this, we end our third answer.